Okay, hello everybody. And I will be talking about constant depth quantum circuits. And I guess the main motivation here is to understand power of parallel quantum algorithms that run in constant time, independent of the problem size. And for example, this constant time cutoff can stem from hardware limitation. Say our qubits usually have only finite coherence time and we have to finish computation before they decohere. And another motivation comes from physics is the theory of topological quantum order. And here constant depth circuits are used to define equivalence classes of multi-qubit states. So we say that two states are equivalent if they can be mapped to each other by a constant depth circuit. And this is a very fruitful way to think of entanglement structures that can emerge in ground states of spin Hamiltonians. And perhaps more relevant for this talk is the idea of a quantum advantage or a quantum supremacy. So it is strongly believed that constant depth quantum circuits are hard to simulate on a classical computer. And so the question is if we can define, if there is some well-defined task that can be solved by constant depth quantum circuits, but which is hard for polynomial depth classical circuits. And just to make sure that we are on the same page, this is a definition of constant depth quantum circuits. So we say that a circuit has depth D if we can divide it into D layers of gates such that gates within each layer act on disjoint subsets of qubits. And each gate acts only on a few qubits, say two or three. And we want this depth to be constant and dependent on the number of qubits. And recently it was shown that indeed there is a computational problem which is easy for constant depth quantum circuits but provably hard for constant depth classical circuits. So any classical circuit that solves the problem must have depth increasing logarithmically with the problem size. And I will tell you what is the problem a bit later. And recently, this result was extended in several ways. So basically, these papers try to make life easier for a classical computer that tries to solve the problem. For example, Kudrin et al. Established average case hardness and also showed that a classical circuit has only exponentially small chance of solving the problem. And then there was amazing result by Wetz et al. And they relaxed the bounded Fanon condition for the classical circuit and proved hardness for AC0 class. And just a few days ago, a new paper appeared by Greer and Schiffer, and they considered interactive version of the problem and proved that it is hard for logarithmic depth classical circuits. And in our work, we try to make life harder for quantum computer. And the first question is whether this quantum advantage is robust to noise. So say quantum circuit is corrupted by noise with some constant noise rate. And I will define my noise model a bit later. This question cannot be addressed just by applying standard quantum error correction techniques. And the problem is that fault-tolerant quantum circuits usually have logarithmic or polylogarithmic depth, and then our quantum advantage result just disappears. And so the quantum circuit that was used in this BJK paper has certain geometric locality. So the circuit only uses nearest neighbor gates on a two-dimensional grid of qubits. And a natural question is whether this quantum advantage persists in one-dimensional geometry when we have just linear array of qubits and nearest neighbor gates. We gave affirmative answer to both questions. So the quantum advantage is indeed robust to noise, and somehow this it persists in the one-dimensional geometry. So these are the main results. But now let me briefly talk about noise. So what do we mean by a noisy circuit? And we used a noise model defined by Aleferis, Gottesman, and Preskill. And say we consider a system of n qubits, and we have random Pauli errors that are drawn from some probability distribution. And we say that such error is a local stochastic noise with noise rate p if it satisfies this condition for any subset of qubits. The probability that each qubit in a subset f suffers from non-identity error, like x, y, or z, must decay exponentially with size of this subset. So high weight errors are exponentially suppressed. And this noise model has several nice properties. For example, multiplication of Pauli errors preserves the local stochasticity. So we can merge several errors into one at the cost of slightly increasing the noise rate. And by definition, Clifford circuits map Pauli errors to Pauli errors. And it turns out that constant depth Clifford circuits preserve local stochasticity. So we can propagate an error through one or several layers of Clifford gates at the cost of slightly increasing the noise rate. So this is very elegant noise model. A noisy quantum circuit is obtained from the ideal one by inserting local stochastic noise after each layer of gates, after the initial state preparation, and before the final measurement. We require that the marginal distribution of each individual error, like E1 or E2, is a local stochastic noise with rate p. And for simplicity, I'm assuming that all operations have the same noise rate, but this is not essential. And this is our result. We describe a computational problem which can be solved with high probability by a noisy constant depth quantum circuit subject to local stochastic noise, provided the noise rate is below some constant threshold. And moreover, this circuit is geometrically local on a three-dimensional grid of qubits. At the same time, we prove that any classical circuit with bounded Fanon gates that solve the problem must have roughly logarithmic depth, as shown here. And the proof is information theoretical, so we don't need any conjectures. Now it's a good time to describe this computational problem. And let me start from a gate set. So the notion of constant depth circuits is gate set dependent, and this is my quantum gate set. So we have Hadamard gate, phase shift gate, and a two-qubit controlled node gate. But each of these gates can be controlled by a classical bit B. So if B is zero, we do nothing, and if B is one, we apply the gate. And any circuit that can be expressed using this gate set is essentially a Clifford circuit, classically controlled Clifford circuit. So we have this control string B, and each gate in the circuit is controlled by one bit of B. And now we imagine applying this circuit to the initial zero state, and at the end of the day, we measure each qubit and we obtain some string of outcomes Z. And we consider this simulation problem. Given control string B, find some output Z that appears with non-zero probability in the output of this circuit. And just by definition, this problem is easy for constant depth quantum circuits because any circuit can efficiently simulate itself. Yes, so I forgot to say that U of B must be constant depth. So this BGK paper gave example of a constant depth controlled Clifford circuit, which is hard to simulate for constant depth classical circuits. So the classical circuit takes as input control string B, perhaps some random bits, and output a string Z, which is supposed to be a solution of a simulation problem from the previous slide. And if the classical circuit succeeds with high probability, its depth must be lower bounded by this function. So n is the number of qubits, and k is a fan-in. Now, what happens if we add noise? Let me first describe a naive approach, and we will see what breaks down. And the naive approach is to encode each qubit. So we start from this classically controlled constant depth Clifford circuit, and we encode each qubit by some quantum error correcting code, and with high enough distance. And then we prepare, we start by preparing each qubit in the logical zero state. Then we replace each Clifford gate by corresponding logical Clifford gate. At the end of the day, we measure every qubit and apply error correction algorithm to measurement outcomes. And so this red box in the middle is an error. For simplicity, I aggregated all errors at a single time step before the measurement. I can do this using properties of the local stochastic noise that I showed you before. Now, what code do we choose? The first property we want is that our logical Clifford gates must be implemented by a constant depth physical circuit. There are many codes that have this property, for example, topological or concatenated codes. In this case, at least this second box is has constant depth, which is a good starting point. Now, the second property we want is that the code must be able to correct local stochastic noise with some constant noise rate. Again, there are many well-known codes that have this property. In this case, we can choose code distance sufficiently large such that probability of a logical error in the entire circuit is negligible. Then we can just forget about the error and we have ideal simulation. The tricky part is how to make the encoding and error correction in a constant depth. And let me start from the encoding step. What we would like to do is to prepare a logical zero state for some good quantum code by a constant depth quantum circuit. But unfortunately, this is impossible. And it is known that logical states of good quantum codes are they have too much entanglement, constant depth circuits are not powerful enough to prepare such entangled states. And here I show several papers with no-go theorems. Instead, what we can do is to enhance power of constant depth circuits by adding measurements and classical feedback. I want to prepare a logical zero state in a register of m data qubits. Then we bring in several ancillary qubits, apply a constant depth Clifford circuit, and then we measure every ancillary qubit. Depending on the measurement outcome, we apply some Pauli recovery operator to the data register. We require that data register ends up in the desired logical zero state for all possible measurement outcomes. This function that computes the recovery operator could be, does not have to be a constant depth. It could be very deep circuit. Now, what happens if we add noise? Of course, it's unreasonable to expect that a noisy circuit prepares ideal logical state. And the best we can hope for is to prepare the logical state modulo some residual error, and I want this error to be a local stochastic noise. Say, if our state prep circuit has some noise rate P, then the residual error must have some noise rate P prime. And intuitively, if P is small, then P prime should be small. But the problem is that this recovery function can propagate errors very badly. So if a single bit of S is corrupted, it can result in a very high weight residual error. So this single shot property basically says that this situation never happens. So a family of quantum codes admits single shot logical state preparation if somehow we can choose this recovery function such that we have this bound. So as I said, if P is small, then P prime is small. So to recap, we want some quantum code that combines all these properties: constant depth implementation of logical Clifford gates, error threshold for local stochastic noise, and single shot logical state preparation. And luckily, there is indeed a code that meets these properties, and this is the surface code. So a distance d surface code encodes one logical qubit in roughly 2d squared physical qubits. Here I show parity checks. And the hard part is to prove this single shot state preparation property. I don't have time to go into details. Finally, we can define what we call encoded simulation problem. This problem will be easy for noisy constant depth quantum circuits, but hard for constant depth classical circuits. And our solution combines these ideas. We prepare initial logical zero states in a single shot fashion, and we fold error correction and recovery into definition of the problem. So this is the encoded Clifford circuit that I showed you before, but we implement encoding in a single shot fashion. The encoder outputs some feedback string S, and we are supposed to apply recovery operator depending on S. Because recovery is Pauli operator, we can propagate it forward in time and incorporate it into the final measurement. At the end of the day, we fed measurement outcome into error correction algorithm, and it outputs a bit string Z, which is supposed to be output of the ideal circuit. But we have to properly adjust the measurement outcome. And so the problem, this is the problem. It depends on classically controlled Clifford circuit U of B on a quantum error correcting code equipped with single shot state preparation property and error correction algorithm. And so given a control string B, we have to find some feedback string S and some measurement outcome Y such that error corrected outcome appears with non-zero probability in the output of the ideal circuit. And just by definition, this problem is easy for noisy constant depth quantum circuits. We can show that a classical circuit that solves this encoded simulation problem can be promoted to a classical circuit that solves the original simulation problem. And this does not increase the depth and fan-in too much. So the depth is increased only by constant factor, and fan-in is increased only by polylogarithmic factor. And if the original problem is hard for constant depth circuits, we infer that this encoded simulation problem is also hard. And this is basically the result. To establish a quantum advantage in three-dimensional geometry, we need one extra ingredient, and this is a distributed version of magic square games. It gives us noiseless quantum advantage in one-dimensional geometry. Then we encode each qubit by two-dimensional surface code and obtain noisy quantum advantage in 3D. This is easier said than done, but I don't go into details. And I just conclude with some open problems, and thank you for attention.